Good evening, I'm John Carter, and welcome to Poland Daily. Today is the 8th anniversary of the Smolensk Air Disaster, which claimed the lives of the Polish President Lech Kaczyński and dozens of high-ranking political and military leaders. A statue in honour of the 96 victims was unveiled at Piłsudski Square in central Warsaw today.
At precisely 8:41 a.m., the moment in which the presidential plane hit the ground on the fateful day 8 years ago, government representatives laid down flowers in front of the presidential palace. People have traveled from all across of Poland to participate in multiple commemoration events that are taking place today in Warsaw. At 11 a.m., Prime Minister Mateusz Morawiecki, together with government ministers and members of parliament from the ruling Law and Justice Party, laid down flowers in front of a monument dedicated to the victims at the Powązki Military Cemetery. A few minutes past 1 p.m., President Andrzej Duda arrived at the cemetery to pay his respects. Many of the people attending had traveled from far and said that they had come to Warsaw for a day of solemn reflections. I was in my car on my way to work when it happened. I was in shock and couldn't believe it. It's a very sad and a tragedy for Poland. I hope that they will be able to finally reveal the truth about what happened there. I found out about it from TV news. I was very sad about what had happened. I believe that our president was probably assassinated. That is my personal opinion. Millions of Poles are aware of the Smolensk air disaster being the most significant national catastrophe in post-war Poland. They are awaiting a factual report of the investigation to shed light on what actually happened in Smolensk, Russia 8 years ago.
The families of the victims of the Smolensk plane crash, government officials and thousands of people from all over the country gathered at Piłsudski Square to honour those who tragically lost their lives in 2010.
Zostaną teraz z pomnika przez harcerzy zdjęte, a następnie zostanie odegrane hasło Wojska Polskiego.
Where the late president of Poland, Lech Kaczyński, and his late wife are buried, next to the ashes of our national hero, Marshal Piłsudski, there is a sentence in Latin. The sentence, corpora dormint vigilant anime, translates to, the bodies are asleep, the souls stay awake.
Ciała śpią, duchy czuwają.
W modlitwie poświęcenia pomnika modlimy się przede wszystkim.
In our prayer, let us turn our thoughts towards the ones that so tragically passed away and to their families. Let us also pray that this monument will bring us all unity. Apart from the unveiling of the monument for the victims of the Smolensk plane crash, there was also an unveiling of the cornerstone for the monument of the late president of Poland, Lech Kaczyński. This monument is a symbol of not giving in to fear and of returning dignity, the dignity of our country and of our nation.
Godności państwa, godności narodu.
Ten pomnik.
This monument could not have happened without your voices, without your marching for 8 years on the streets of Warsaw and other Polish cities. I am grateful that you remember. At 7 o'clock, there was a special Holy Mass at the St. John's Archcathedral in Warsaw, held in memory of all the 96 victims of the Smolensk plane crash.
Professor Kazimierz Nowiczek, the vice president of the Smolensk Commission, has put an end to media speculation about the report potentially proposing that the subcommittee reinvestigate the 2010 plane crash. He has also stated that what is included in the technical report.
There were no changes. We have never said that we would present the full report in April. I should add that the full document will be very long. There is one attachment that will be 600 pages. In the near future, we will present the technical report, because this is the most important matter.
Will it say what was the cause of the Smolensk plane crash?
Yes, it will.
Can you tell us now what that reason was?
There are two threads. The first one is an explosion in the wing, which tore it from the plane. The second one is the main cause of the crash, which was an explosion in the center of the plane's body. This is also the reason why there were no survivors.
Czyli wybuch w centropłaczu z pokazaniem miejsca lokalizacji epicentrum tego wybuchu.
Will we know what caused the explosions?
My nie badamy przyczyny wybuchów.
We did not investigate the cause of the detonations. That is the responsibility of the prosecution. We only focus on the reason why the plane was shredded into nearly 60,000 pieces.
Since most of us are not experts on the matter, how should we understand the fact that there were two explosions on the aircraft in mid-flight? Will it be explained in the report?
Jak to odczytywać?
To właśnie będzie przedstawione w tym raporcie.
The report will be presenting the most important findings, pointing to the fact that there were detonations on the plane. It will also be presented in a way understandable to the average reader. Let me say this, we have found evidence on the wing that can only be explained by an explosion. There is no doubt about that. We also conducted experiments trying to recreate in a lower scale how the explosions would shred the wing and the body of the plane, and we will present what we have learned in the report.
To są ślady, które nie mogą powstać w trakcie uderzenia.
When can we expect the report to be published? Is it going to happen today, in the next few days or maybe weeks?
W najbliższych dniach.
The public can expect the technical report in the next few days, perhaps even hours.
I ten raport będzie przedstawiony publicznie.
Thank you for joining us a little later than scheduled this evening. I'm John Carter, and Poland Daily returns at the normal time tomorrow. Good night.